Hi everyone, in this video tutorial we will discuss about NDVI. NDVI stands for Normalized Difference Vegetation Index. It is an index to quantify green vegetation. There are many uses of NDVI. This is the basic formula of NDVI, NIR minus red upon NIR plus red, where NIR stands for near infrared. Its value range from minus 1 to 1. Uses of NDVI, for example, through NDVI we can quantify forest type classification, we can delineate water bodies, and many other things we can do with the help of NDVI. Now these are the values certain values with the help of this we can prepare a classified map. Minus 1 to minus 0.1 represents a water body, minus 0.1 to 0.1 represents barren land. Barren land may be a rock surface, snow or sand. 0.2 to 0.4 represents shrubs or very scarce vegetation, and 0.4 to 1 represents a vegetation, generally forest area. So we in this video tutorial we will quantify NDVI with the help of a satellite image. Now upload a satellite image in the Ardas Imagine software. Now this is a mosaic data. We need to find NDVI of this. For this go to raster option. Go to unsupervised and here it is written NDVI. Click it here. Now this image is of Landsat 5. We know the we know that in Landsat 5, band 4 represents NIR and band 3 represents red band. This is the formula of NDVI. So automatically band 4 is band 4 and band 3 are ticked by this software. If we this is of Landsat 5. Similarly of Landsat 5, 4 and 3 are ticked. 4 represents NIR and band 3 represent red. Now create the path. You need to save the NDVI map. I'm simply writing NDVI map .img, give extension. You not need to give an extension. Okay. Then click it OK. Okay, now you can remove this mosaic data. Upload the file. I've saved it as NDVI map. Now upload it here. Now you can see this is a black and white map. This is a NDVI map. Here the positive value represents, here the bright value, that is white portion, represents a vegetation, and black represents a water body, generally a water body. So we can analyze better in ArcGIS software. So upload the NDVI map here also to better interpretate NDVI map. Now see. Now if we have to classify our study area, you can extract the study area from NDVI map also. It can be done by extraction by mask. I'm doing it. drag this entity into the raster. This shapefile here, set the path, I'm writing it as study and dvi. Save. Now you can save the data. You can remove this. You can export the data first to save the data, or first let us classify the map instead of exporting. Now go to, right click this option, go to properties, go to symbology, and go to classified. It depends upon you how much classes you class you want to take. For example, I am taking 5 classes. Now you can break the values for better studying the NDVI and for classification. Now I have written the values, for example water body. Now you have to break the point to -0.1. Now I'm breaking the break values. And next value is breaked at 0.1. Next we can break it to 0.2. Next 0.4. Next it is 0.74, because it's the highest value. We cannot write as plus 1, because the highest value itself is 0.74, so do it okay. Now this value is water body, -0.76 to -0.1, it is water body. So we can change the color as blue. We can take it the color as blue, write it here water. Here it is of barren land. Here I am taking the color as brown. This is unclassified. I am writing it, I am just simply taking no color, and I am writing it as unclassified. Now this is of shrub. I am taking the color as, for example, I am taking the color as this orange. I am taking this color as orange, taking as shrub. Now highest values go for forest, taking as green, writing as forest or vegetation simply. Now apply. See, we can better understand this image now. If you you can save this, but when you save this file, it will automatically, the file created will be of black and white. It is not this. So thank you all for watching this video.